To provide additional information about HTML elements, you need to get familiar with attributes. Attributes can provide more details about an element. They're always specified in the start tag of an element and usually come in name/value pairs like this. One type of attribute is href, like in this example. Links are defined with the A tag, and the link address or URL is specified in the href attribute. Another type of attribute is src. We call that source, like in this example. HTML images are defined with the img tag, and the image source or URL is defined by the src attribute. Images in HTML have a set of size attributes. These correspond to the width and height of an image. For instance, an image size with a width of 500 equates to 500 pixels wide. If you change the width to 300, the image will become smaller. The style attribute is used to specify the look or style of an element. This is called CSS, and you'll learn about that in another chapter. For now, you just need to know that CSS allows you to change colors, sizes, and set the layout of your page. The language of the document can be declared in the HTML tag with the lang attribute. This is important for screen readers and search engines. The title attribute specifies a title for an element. The value of this title is displayed as a tooltip when you move the mouse over the element. Double quotes around attribute values are the most common, but single quotes can also be used. And sometimes you actually have to use both. For instance, if an attribute value contains double quotes, it is necessary to use single quotes around it, or vice versa. So remember, if you want to change something about an element, you will probably need an attribute.